G'day everyone, Ian Fegan here, also known as Professor Shoelace. Now I've previously done a video showing the difference between a correctly tied reef knot and an incorrectly tied granny knot, which one sits straight and stays secure, the other one sits crooked and tends to come undone. Now a recent study by the University of California, Berkeley, also looked into these knots, and one of their conclusions was there are two ways to tie the common shoelace bow tie knot, and one is stronger than the other, but no one knows why. So in this video, I'll show you why a granny knot actually comes undone. And to do that, I'll use a piece of rope, which I've got here. And I'll begin by tying a reef knot the way I tie, which is a left over right starting knot, followed by a right over left finishing knot. You could do the same thing in reverse, right over left, followed by left over right. And this forms a reef knot, which is basically the same as the knot that you use for shoelaces, without the extra loops that form the drawstrings that let you pull it undone. Now, you'll notice it's nice and balanced. It's basically two loops sort of intertwined. And what you have is one loop, the end from the shoe goes through this loop, goes in there, around, and back out again. And here you have a contact point between the lower knot and the upper knot. And that is where friction occurs, such that when you pull this end, notice that's pulling in that direction, and it'll also pull the adjacent contact point with it in that direction, pulling the knot tight. Same on the other side, we've got this one coming out through this loop, around and back in through that loop. So any tension in this direction pulls that bit with it and pulls the knot tight. So when we actually do it, notice the knot just basically gets tighter and tighter. Now, on the other hand, when we tie a granny knot, which is here I've got a left over right starting knot, followed by a left over right finishing knot. First thing you notice is that it really doesn't form a nice neat knot. Second thing is that the same loose end, which goes in through this loop, around, and then goes in through the same loop. So the contact point there means that tension coming out this way will tend to pull that bit out with it. And that'll pull the knot undone. So I'll simulate this tension, which is basically the same as the tension of your laces in your shoe, because all of this bit will be within your shoe. When you pull there, you'll notice it just pulls apart. That'll just keep pulling, keep slipping, and eventually, bang, it's right undone. So that's why a granny knot comes undone. And if you want more information about granny knots and how they relate to shoelaces, you can go to Ian's shoelace site.